At exactly 2 p.m., the hearse containing the remains of the late Justice Kenneth Kakuru arrived at the judiciary headquarters at Kampala High Court. Right away, the processions kicked off. Judges of the High Court and the Supreme Court were the first to enter, and these were followed by the justices of the Court of Appeal. As the session kicked off, the Deputy Attorney General Jackson Kafuzi Karugaba presented an application to honor the late Justice Kakuru. This was supported by an affidavit signed by the Judiciary Chief Registrar Sarah Langusiu. Members of the Uganda Law Society who acted in defense of the application also concurred with the application on grounds that the deceased was a human rights defender who served the judiciary with dedication since 2013. This also presented an affidavit signed by the Uganda Law Society Secretary.
Testimonies and tributes from all the senior lawyers, from all the young lawyers, even from the students who've had a chance to interact with him. He is described as a disciplinarian who wanted the best out of the bat.
He's satisfied that this is a fit and proper application for which leave should be granted to the judicial officers and staff of the judiciary to commemorate the life and contribution of Honorable Justice Kenneth Kakuru for the distinguished services he rendered to the people of Uganda.
Other judicial officers eulogized the late Kakuru as a backlog fighter who always dedicated his life to work, that even in his frail health, he would always deliver rulings on time.
Backlog fighter, very transparent. He would write his judgment and sign it, and the whole public would get it immediately. This business of, I cannot find this judgment. No, judgment finished. Some of us have been infected, but I think for good reasons. But it is my sincere hope and prayers that colleagues in the judiciary, that as we speak now in this era, the work is simply too much.
Utilization of public resources, of performance, time management, and value for money in the operations of the Court of Appeal Constitutional Court. We have no doubt that this attribute of accountability runs through every facet of the public and private life of Justice Kakuru.
Samantha Atkunda, the daughter of the deceased, who spoke on behalf of the family, described her father as a man that always represented the less privileged members of society. She revealed that even on his hospital bed, he was able to write a ruling of a case he was presiding over.
What he did, he loved his work as a justice. During court vacation, he would organize all his pending files and use his vacation to complete all pending cases. Like we have heard, he was a backlog fighter. About 2 weeks ago, while he was sick and frail in Nairobi, he asked me to help him. There was a pending judgment that he hadn't finished, but he was too frail to do it.
Justice Richard Butera, who led the panel of five justices that presided over the session, also eulogized the deceased as an exemplary judge who would go an extra mile to ensure that justice prevailed.
His time as administrator, the Court of Appeal developed a strategy to improve case disposal, greatly cutting down on existing case backlog. We also recall that when Justice Kenneth Kakuru was not well, he continued to work even when he was on a hospital bed.
Plans which we do not understand, his are not ours. Justice Kenneth Kakuru has unexpectedly left us to be with the Lord. We can only pray that the Almighty God be pleased to accept his soul as his servant in eternal glory. The judiciary, the legal fraternity, and the country at large, and these many members have said, have lost a fair-minded judicial officer that you think of with the permanent secretary to the judiciary, to ensure that we got funds to have Justice Kakuru treated in the best cancer hospitals in the world.
After the speeches, Justice Butera granted an application for these proceedings to be made a public record of the Court of Appeal.
And made part of the permanent record of the court, and a copy be distributed to the family.
Record of the Court of Appeal, a copy of the proceedings of this court today shall be provided to the family.
Justice Kakuru died on Tuesday in Nairobi, Kenya at Aga Khan Hospital. Yesterday, his body was returned. Tomorrow, a requiem service will be held at All Saints Cathedral in Nakasero, after which the body will be taken to Rebu Shure in Mbarara, where he will be buried on Saturday afternoon. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.